So what does it mean to have good rough water handling? That's been a question that a lot of people have thrown at the Watercraft Journal again and again and again. And unfortunately, a lot of times, people don't really know exactly what they're asking for. Are they asking for a watercraft that will soak up and absorb a lot of the chatter and vibrations that come up through rough water, up through the hull and into the seat and up through the handlebars? Are they looking for a watercraft that can handle and swoop and churn while rough water? Or are they looking for a watercraft that can maintain a good through line and not really wander or bow steer as they run through the chop? These are all different kind of attributes that a watercraft can and can't do. Now, when it comes to exploring the different kinds of riding styles that you may have, a lot of people just go, hey, I just ride really fast, or I want something really comfortable, or I want something reliable. All of these things were taken into account when Yamaha sought to redesign the new 2019 FX SVHO Limited. Now, obviously, the FX platform itself got an entire refresh for 2019. What we have today, the FX Limited with the SVHO engine package, is of course Yamaha's flagship. When it came time for Yamaha to redesign the FX platform, they took into account a vast variety of input from different categories of riders. Obviously, we have the performance bred hot dogger, but we also have the casual cruiser. They wanted to find a platform that could be accessible by all of those people. In that, Yamaha found that they could actually learn quite a bit from the hull design of the GP 1800 and 1800R. They found that in designing a larger full-size watercraft that could comfortably seat three and have a lot more storage, they found that in addition to maintaining some rough water handling, wherein it'll keep a nice, straight, true, predictable path through rough water, it could also have a very solid lean-in and churn. That gives it a little bit more of a motorcycle feel. And while you're going into a churn, you put a little bit more weight and you ride right around. You're not churning flat and you have a really more natural feel to your churns. In addition, the FX is able to provide far more stability and predictability when handling in rough water, glass, or what have you. The FX Limited SVHO and all other supercharged Yamahas that are on the FX platform all enjoy the lightweight Nano XL 2 deck and hull material. This drops the watercraft down to a very impressive 818 pounds. That's 13 pounds lighter than the previous FX and 10 pounds lighter than Sea-Doo's competitor. Impressively enough, Yamaha was able to achieve this lightweight even while adding an inch of length and half an inch of width, and increasing the total overall storage to a whopping 44 pounds. This new increased storage can be found most prominently in the bow storage that now is large enough to contain its own soft-sided cooler, as well as a very impressive padded glove box that also has a patented waterproof lid. The glove box itself is impressively large, even so much that we could fit our own digital camera inside of it, a hat, and a tow rope. The seat of the FX Limited SVHO is of a cut-and-sew high-quality pattern and features a very nice heat-resistant material so it won't burn your legs while you're riding. Another impressive feature for the new FX platform is Yamaha's wider and more padded folding swim step, making it almost a shelf or a full stair to climb back into the watercraft. Obviously, the biggest addition to the new FX platform is the redesigned cockpit and new data center. The new Yamaha Connect touchscreen allows the rider to toggle through several different pages to personalize their watercraft. You can change the screen. You can even see what your trip hours are, total miles. You can even get a fuel info page. This fuel info page will give you miles per gallon, miles to empty, and your hourly miles as you proceed along your trip. Additionally, there's other features like setting a different drive control, that'll allow you to program the watercraft for a maximum speed, just in case you're putting a friend on who may or may not be as comfortable with a supercharged watercraft as you may be. Next, we have a really neat feature that allows you to change your display. We can even change your background color to 9 different settings. For the FX platform, Yamaha paired up with RAM mounts, knowing that many of you long distance and fishing enthusiasts are using RAM mounts already on your Yamahas. That pairing of these two companies has allowed for a whole new accessory group that allows the watercraft enthusiasts of all types to be able to find an attachment that they can put on their watercraft. For the FX Limited, the package includes 2 of the new Bluetooth speakers, as well as the Garmin GPS. The RAM mounts are universal. As you come up, you can unscrew this, the mount comes off, and here you have a Virgin perch that you can put any other attachment on. Or, with the use of an Allen wrench, you can pop this mount off and insert a cup holder. So you're not even losing the cup holder like you had in the previous FX platforms. The Nano X Gear speaker system is unique to the Yamaha watercraft in that it is Bluetooth compatible with your smartphone, in addition to syncing with the other speaker so that both will play at the same time. You can control your volume either by toggling on the speaker itself or off of your phone. The Garmin GPS is also unique in that it's also hardwired to the battery as well as a transom mounted depth sounder. This in turn gives the FX Limited SVHO a very unique advantage over the rest of the Yamaha lineup in that it is fully equipped with almost the entire catalog's worth of accessories. There's a whole accessory line that's associated with the FX Limited that's worth checking out in our full-length article that we've attached in the description of this video. Even with all the accessories left at the dock, the FX Limited SVHO is an absolutely well-rounded machine. We found that cruising casually, it's super comfortable, it's naturally intuitive, and rider input is very minimal. But when we will really want to get on the throttle and we get up high up over the bars, we toggle down just 1 or 2 notches on the electric trim, and suddenly we have a race-bred watercraft. And whether it's glass, going through coves, or chasing boats and running through their wakes, this watercraft never loses traction. That's the most important thing, is that it's an incredibly predictable watercraft. Where you point it, it goes. That, my friends, is what we mean by rough water handling. Regardless of how much chatter it absorbs, which is quite a bit, or how rough those waves are that you're pounding through, the watercraft, particularly the FX platform, is naturally hooked and stays online where you point it. We at the Watercraft Journal earnestly believe that the FX platform, especially equipped with the SVHO package, is going to become the rough water watercraft for the next 8, 9, 10 years. This is the machine that we believe people of every stripe are going to flock to when it comes to comfort, reliability, predictability, and overall performance. I'm Kevin Shaw, and you've been watching Long Haul. Make sure to check us out Monday through Friday at www.watercraftjournal.com. And make sure to like and subscribe to this video so that you don't miss any more as we update every week and twice a month with Long Haul.